Phosphorus cycle is an important biogeochemical cycle through which phosphorus is circulated in lithosphere, hydrosphere, and biosphere. Phosphorus is really an important element in all living organisms. Phosphorus is required for healthy growth of bones. Phosphorus is also needed for growth and development of teeth. Moreover, phosphorus is also needed for the formation of genetic material like DNA. So in DNA, there is a long chain of phosphorus which forms backbone of DNA. So phosphorus is an element which is definitely needed. However, this phosphorus, which is widely utilized by living organisms for their growth and development, is not available in atmosphere. Therefore, this cycle is known as sedimentary biogeochemical cycle. And the reason is that phosphorus does not cycle through atmosphere. So the main reservoir of phosphorus is available in the form of rock. Let us study phosphorus cycle in detail. So phosphorus cycle starts with rock. So major reservoir of phosphorus is in rock, and this need to be available for all living organisms. Therefore, the first step is disintegration of rock into simpler form. So disintegration of rock is possible with the help of the process known as weathering. In weathering, physical, chemical, or biological agents break rock into simpler form, and ultimately dissolved phosphorus is available in soil. This dissolved phosphorus can be utilized by all plants, and therefore plants can use this available phosphorus for the formation of leaves, stem, and other body parts. Further, as soon as this phosphorus enters plants, therefore plants will be consumed by herbivore and herbivore will be consumed by carnivore. And in the food web, phosphorus get easily circulated. So all animals will be able to utilize their phosphorus content for growth and development of their body parts. Ultimately, after death of these animals, phosphorus will be released in soil and the formation of rock will start. Second point is that phosphorus rock is also mined artificially for making fertilizers. Fertilizers are artificial chemicals rich in nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, which are added in the crop field and thereby they boost agricultural output. Therefore, fertilizers are important for the growth of plants or trees. The dissolved phosphorus, which is available after the process of weathering, may also get washed away with rainfall and may join nearby ocean or lake. This dissolved phosphorus, which is now available in ocean water, will be utilized by aquatic plants. So all aquatic plants will be able to use this phosphorus content for their growth and development. Aquatic plants will be further consumed by aquatic animals like fish, and therefore marine animals have high reservoir of phosphorus in their body. So phosphorus will be utilized by all aquatic plants and animals. There are certain seabirds which feed on fishes. So seabirds dive in seawater and feed on fishes. These seabirds, they have high content of phosphorus in their body. Whenever these seabirds travel on the terrestrial areas, there they release excretory waste, which is known as guano. So guano, the excretory waste of seabird, is extremely rich in phosphorus content and thereby provides source of nutrition to plants or trees. And like this, phosphorus gets circulated in all living forms. Large amount of phosphorus may get washed away with rain and may join ocean floor. Now here, the first rock of ocean is known as continental shelf. So phosphorus which get washed away with rain may accumulate in the continental shelf. Further, the insoluble deposit of phosphorus which get deposited in the continental shelf of ocean may get exposed after millions of years when crustal plate rises up. So as soon as the crustal plate rises up from the seafloor, phosphates and phosphorus content will be exposed to the land. There is one problem with phosphorus cycle, and it is known as eutrophication. So nowadays, eutrophication is causing lot of imbalances in ecology. Let us see what is eutrophication. Fertilizers which are synthesized after mining phosphorus from rock are applied to the soil. Whenever these fertilizers get washed away with rain, they may join nearby pond, lake or any other water body. In that case, fertilizers which are usually rich in phosphorus and also nitrogen, they become source of nutrition for the growth of algae. And these lakes, pond or any other stagnant water body may get totally covered up with algae. This is known as algal bloom or eutrophication. And with the proliferated growth of algae, inner aquatic organisms present in pond or lake, for example fish, insects, etc., may ultimately die and ecosystem of pond will collapse. Let's see some of the questions which are asked in UPSC prelim. So the first question is, there is a concern over increase in harmful algal bloom in the seawater of India. What could be the factors for this phenomena? First, discharge of nutrients from estuaries. Second, runoff from the land during monsoon. Third, upwelling in the seas. This question can be easily correlated with algal bloom. And algal bloom is the phenomena which take place in seawater or any other water body whenever there is high amount of nutrient content. So first option is directly related to the nutrient. So discharge of nutrient from estuaries. So whenever there is mixing of nutrient, lot of nutrients are available and that may cause algal growth. So first option is correct. Runoff from the land during monsoon. So runoff from the land, especially the water which is rich in fertilizers, may ultimately result in more nitrogen and phosphorus content in sea. So this option is also correct. Third option is upwelling in the sea. Upwelling means a phenomena by which the water which is present in the lower surface of ocean gets circulated on the top. So by upwelling process, the nutrients get mixed up and ultimately with more availability of nutrients, algal growth can take place. So in this, the correct options are 1, 2 and 3. So the option D is correct. Let's see another question. Consider the following statement. Phosphorus is responsible for excessive growth of rooted and free-floating microscopic plants in water body. Now we know that eutrophication or algal bloom is the phenomena which is correlated with accumulation of phosphorus. And we know that during eutrophication or algal bloom, there is proliferated growth of free-floating microscopic plants. So algae are nothing but free-floating microscopic plant and therefore first option is correct. Second, chlorofluorocarbon play a major role in eutrophication? No, actually chlorofluorocarbons are related to ozone depletion. Phosphorus cycle has no correlation with chlorofluorocarbons. So the option is one only. Third question, eutrophication can be most appropriately defined as enhanced plankton growth due to excess supply of nutrients, amount of dissolved oxygen needed to break down the organic material, an increase in the concentration of nutrient as you move up the food chain, a decrease in biotic potential of aquatic ecosystem. So out of all these, you can easily make out that eutrophication is a process by which plankton growth or algal growth increases due to excessive nutrient supply. So with this, we have completed phosphorus cycle. Keep watching Neha Green Planet for more information on environment. Thank you.